The production of this video was made possible by donors to the Orchestration Online Patreon initiative. Please consider adding your support to the creation of free educational internet resources by visiting our Patreon page linked below.
Hey there, this is your orchestration tutor, Thomas Goss, sharing one last tip with you from the new updated second edition of 100 Orchestration Tips: trombone roles and relationships. Trombones have an enormous variety of uses, which range far beyond obvious examples in modern film scoring. There's a trap laid for developing orchestrators whose instincts are heavily influenced by film scoring. Following those instincts may very well limit the wider use of certain instruments, one of which is the humble trombone. Clear your mind of all other thoughts and imagine the trombone in the context of film scoring. What immediately springs to mind? Usually two roles, either playing huge menacing lines, holding down the bass line in massive tooties. More perceptive listeners may also think of its use in conjunction with the trumpets in a more heroic style. Of course, film orchestrators commonly use trombones in many different ways, but they're rarely exposed in this context. This means that the student orchestrators got less context for its use than the horns or the trumpets, who are customarily given far more play as melodic resources in either film or concert music. What's needed is some serious score reading to fully understand the trombone's flexibility, if not indispensability. It's easiest to understand this through examining the orchestral relationships of the trombone. The most obvious place to start is in perceiving the trombones as part of a low brass section with the tuba. This association is so common that in older scores, trombones 1 and 2 are placed on one staff, with bass trombone and tuba sharing the other below. For those works, the two lower instruments are partners, often playing the same heavy notes at unison or octaves. This eventually became a bit of a cliché with time, especially as more sophisticated orchestrators saw fit to separate the tuba out from this enclave due to its unique sonority. Nevertheless, the lower heavy brass continue to form a solid rank in some scoring. The next important relationship for the trombones is with the trumpets. In fact, in some types of scoring, this connection is far more important than that of the tuba. As noted in Chapter 30 from 100 Orchestration Tips, Brass Section Seating, both trumpet and trombone principal players sit side by side, and often play duo or conjointly lead their groups. Though I personally reject the notion that the trombone is just a big trumpet, there's no question that the two timbres can work together seamlessly if each individual instrument is placed in its strongest range. A less obvious relationship is that of the trombones with the horns, and yet the two work beautifully together. A single trombone can stabilize the low note of a horn harmony, or lend a sense of power to the top note. the two groups can easily interlock for an integrated, more widely spread harmony. Or double chords for a closer, more intense sound that's incredibly dark. An immensely serious sound occurs with horns and trombones doubling at the octave or in octaves. Or call-and-response fanfares between the two groups can explore their similarities and differences. The trombone tends to obliterate the strings and winds at louder dynamic levels, and dominate them at lower to middle levels. Nevertheless, carefully balanced textures can be devised to keep some of this under control. Similar to the trumpet, in Chapter 37, trumpet soloing and doubling, doubling with certain instruments is undertaken more to amend the tone of the trombone. Bassoons plus bass trombone is great for the trombonist, though not so good for the bassoonists. Bass clarinet plus trombone is a bit better, with a certain hollowness cleaning up the rougher characteristics of the trombone, yet the intonation may be tricky to sort. The safest relationships to the other orchestral sections, of course, are of complete contrast, joining in on a tutti bass line, or complementary harmony. Chapter 41, Trombone Power Projection, covered some of this ground already, mentioning the use of trombones as a background textural element. In this video, I'll add that there's a certain glow that the trombones seem to possess, or lend to a texture when they sit behind it, similar to a horn pad, but more distant and glossy. They're used in this way far more than the casual or even more informed listener might suspect. What's taken for granted in all these considerations, sometimes to the point of being ignored or neglected, is the trombone's role as rhythmic component. Offbeats, cross rhythms, and strange subdivisions of the beat are all fantastic for the trombones as a group or individually, as the crisp attack has a naturally percussive quality. This can relate very well to the percussion and help them to propel the energy of a passage with greater conviction and solidity. None of these roles and relationships change the bottom line about the trombones. They're exceedingly powerful in any combination, even with tubas and trumpets, and they require a great deal more breath than most other instruments, so any relationship must compensate when working synchronously on an extended line. Of course, there are so many other great ways that trombones can interact with the orchestra, you'll just have to do some score reading of your own. You can start with the framing music I've been using for this video, Mahler's Second Symphony. One key role that I didn't mention in the original tip was trombone as a featured soloist, such as in this passage from the fifth movement. Or in the fantastic lower heavy brass chorale from earlier in that movement, with all four trombones soli, plus tuba and contrabassoon. Here's a little taste of it for you to score read. Enjoy, and I'll see you soon.